So good morning class. In the last lecture we have seen putting the DC gentry and how the DC gentry is called. Okay. So in the today's lecture we will see the some numerical problem and implementation of DC gentry. Okay. So here we are take some example using the some numerical value. Okay. For the numerical value, how to implement the DC gentry. So here I am taking the one example. So let us consider I have the one data set with attribute age, competition, type and product. Okay. So this is very randomly I am taking one of the data set. So one first attribute is age, then second attribute is our competition, the third attribute is the type, and the fourth one is called the profit. Okay. And they have the respective data. In my data set, I have the 10 records in which few value are assigned as old, in age attribute, few value are assigned as mid, and few value are assigned as new in age attribute. In competition, yes and no attribute. In types, there are the two type of attribute, software and hardware. And in profit, there is the up and the down attribute values. Okay. So before we start to decision tree, following four steps you have to keep in your mind. Okay. So whenever you start the decision tree, or whenever you want to solve the decision tree. So following four conditions are very important, or following four steps are very important. Okay. So what are the steps? The first step, to find the target or the plan. Okay. So what is the target? What target we have to achieve from this data set? Okay. So from the data set, I want to give the prediction that if there is a profit, my product is in profit or not. So this is my target, to find out the my target is going, my profit is going up or going down. So whenever you receive a data set, first you find out that attribute, which attribute is called a target attribute, or also called as a class attribute. So in this example, I am considering the my target attribute is a profit. Then the next step, you have to find the information gain, that is called as the IG value of the target. So once you find out your target value, the next step you have to find out the information gain, it is called as the IG. In the next step, you have to find out the entropy for deciding the root of the gain. Okay, so as you know that if you are considering the root, if you are considering the tree, so root is important. Okay, so either you can learn this concept in the data structure, or normal also in general life, you can see that if there is a tree, so there must be a root. So without a root, there is no tree. Same concept, what we have to find out in the next third step, we have to find out the entropy. And this entropy is used for deciding the what is your root of the tree. Okay. So once you decide, once you fix the root of your tree, so the next step will be, you can continue with your different branches. Okay. So at the end, find the gain of each attribute. Okay. So there is a little bit difference between the information gain and your gain. Okay. So information gain is, the information gain we have to find out for the target attribute, while the gain, only gain, we have to find out for the each attribute. Okay. So I hope all of you now get an idea about a decision tree. Right. So again I repeat in a few steps. So first there is some data set. So you must require the some data set to design the decision tree. Out of that data set, the first step you have to find out is to target attribute. It is also called as a class attribute. The first step you have to work with the decision tree is to find out the target attribute or class attribute. In the next stage, we have to find out the information gain. So, this is called the information gain. The information gain of target attribute. And in the last, in the third stage, you have to find out the entropy. The entropy is to decide the root of the tree. And at the end, you have to find out the only gain. And the gain of each attribute. So, whatever the attribute you have in your data set. So, in this our example, we have the three attributes. For example, age, competition and the time, while profit is my target attribute. Okay, so I ignore my attribute profit because it is a target attribute. So I am not considering to find out the gain of profit attribute. I am finding out the information gain of the target attribute. Okay, so these are the four steps. Now, next step, what you have to do? Find out the decision tree. So now you have to find out the information gain. So, to find out the information gain, write down properly, this is the formula to find out the information gain. So, this is the standard formula to find out the information gain is equal to whole bracket minus P of P plus N log 2 P divided by P plus N minus N divided by P plus N log 2 into n divided by p plus n. Okay. So, here there are the two variables we are considering while we are finding out the information gain of target attribute. Okay. See, why I am taking this information gain of target attribute? Because target attribute is always a binary. Okay. Keep in mind that your target attribute must be either true or false, yes or no, or you can be say that it is a binary value or 1 or 0. Okay. Because you can take a decision. So, what do you mean by decision? Either you can go for that or neither you cannot go for that. So, in that condition only you have to take the decision. So, I will play the match or I will not play the match. So, tomorrow will be holiday or tomorrow will not be a holiday. So, there is a either condition, or either it is true or either it is false. So, that's why in this formula you can see that there are only two value we are considering, that is called as a P and the N. So, P is indicating the positive and N is indicating the negative. So, in my example, so in my previous data set example, I considering the whatever the value that is down is a P and the N is the my up value. Okay. So, you can take anything. Okay. So, as per the information gain, so information gain is equal to minus P divided by P plus N log of 2 multiplied by P and by P plus N minus N by P plus N log 2 of N divided by P plus N. So, this is a standard formula to find out the information. In the next stage, you have to find out the entropy. So, in previous slide, we have seen that there are the four states. So, in the next stage, you have to find out the entropy. So, to find out the entropy, the formula is E of A is indicated as entropy, summation of I equal to 1 to N, Pi plus Ni divided by P plus N into mod of Pi into Ni. So, I is indicating the information gain. Okay. So, I is indicating your information gain of the attribute into probability of attribute. Right. And the fourth stage in the last slide we are seeing that finally you have to find out the gain of all attributes. Gain for all attributes. Here we have the three attributes. Okay. So, the gain will be the whose gain will be the greatest. Those gain will be the greatest. It should be called as a root of the tree. Okay, so why we find out the gain of remaining attribute? Because those attribute gain is the maximum value, we consider that attribute as a root of the decision tree. Okay, so gain is equal to IG. What is IG? IG is my information gain minus E of A. What is E of A? E of A is my entropy of my given attribute. Okay. So, this is our formula. So, write down this formula carefully. So, using these three formulas, we have to now solve the decision tree. So, to solve the numerical value of decision tree, we must have know the these three formulas. So, write down properly. Okay. So, in the next step, what we have to do? Now, Continuing with our previous example, previous data set, there are the four attributes: age, competition, type, and the profit. Out of that, the profit is my target attribute. So I am considering the profit as my target attribute. Then there are the different normal attribute are age, competition, and the type. Okay. So first step, you have to find out the information. What is information gain? The information gain you have to find out for target attribute. Okay. So what is my target attribute? My target attribute is my profit. Now, in my target attribute, how many records in my target attribute? There are the 10 records. So I have 10. And how many up and how many down here? There are the 5 up and the 5 down. Okay. So the first, as per the formula, host minus 1 minus divided by 5 divided by 10. So what is that 5? 5 I am considering here as a P. So P is down. So how many down is here? Here the down are the 5. So 5 divided by 10 log of 2, 5 divided by 10 plus 5 by 10 divided by log 2, 5 by 10. No. What is that different 5? 5 again, there are the n. So n value here also the up is how many up are there? There are the 5. So that's why 5 by 10 and 5 by 10 are the both sides are the same. Now move to the next. Minus 0.5. So when you divide the 5 by 10, so it is nothing but the 0.5. Great. So 0.5 log of 2 raised to the power minus 1. So you can find out, and then the finally you can find out in the third step, minus 0.5 multiplied by minus 1 log of 2 of 2 plus 0.5 minus 1 into log of 2 of 2. So this is nothing but the minus 1 minus 0.5, because log of 2 is equal to nothing but 1. So 0.5 multiplied by minus 1 is minus 0.5. Minus 0.5 is equal to minus 1. And minus minus is equal to plus. Okay. So the IG value, you will get the plus 1. Okay, so this is the first step to find out the information gain of target attribute. Okay, so using this, you can find out the information gain of target attribute profit. In the next step, you have to find out the entropy of each attribute. Right, so in the next step, it is very small, you have to consider it. While finding out the entropy of each attribute, okay, so you have to again create one small table. You can see at the top of left hand side. So here I am considering the first attribute. So my first attribute is age, my second attribute is competition, and my third attribute is the type. Right? So I am considering the first attribute age. Now in my age attribute, how many different value are there? In my age attribute, there are the 3 different values. Which are that? Old, mid, and the new. Okay, so you can consider this old, mid, and the new. And in association with your target attribute, you can take down and up. Okay, now very interesting now. So in my age attribute, how many old value? There are the 3 value. Mid value, okay, so mid value, but as per the down, so how many are there? There are 2 only. And mid value for the up, there are again 2, and for the new, for the down, there is a 0, but for the up, there is a 3. Okay, so first you have to properly write down this table for the attribute, which attribute you are going for to find out the entropy. So here I am going to find out the entropy of an attribute H. So I am taking this small table. Okay, so in that attribute, how many different value? There are the 3 different value. So I keep it there in the row, that is old, mid, and the new. And at the column, you can see that there are the down and up. Right? So down, in considering with old, okay, all old are similar, matching with the down, so there are the 3. Then mid, you can see that there are the 2 down and the 2 up, right? And
while new, there is no down in a new, but there are the up value only the with the new value. Okay, so this is a small table you have to consider. It is on the top of the data set. Now move to the formula. Enthalpy is nothing but what you see that is the information gain, okay, multiplied by the probability of that value. Okay, so if you want to find out the enthalpy, so another way to find out the enthalpy is nothing but information gain multiplied by the probability of that particular value. Okay, so what I am doing here, I am considering the information gain of my old value. So information gain of old is equal to minus 3 by 3 plus how many up value is there? Okay, there are the old value are 3, okay, and 0 divided by 3 multiplied by log 2 0 by 3. Okay, so when you find out this, it is nothing but the 0, okay, and the probability of old value out of 10. So why I am taking the out of 10? Because they are the 10 record, my total record are 10. Okay, so you can find out the probability of old is equal to 3 divided by 10. So 0 into 3 divided by 10 is nothing but 0. So whatever you are multiply by the 0 is nothing but 0. So that's why the information of old is nothing but the 0. Okay, I hope all of you understand. Now find out the mid value. So mid value mein dekhe, mid value minus 2 by 4. Okay, so C you can consider as a down and N is considered as a F. And so 2 plus 2, 4, 2 divided by 4 into log 2, 2 by 4 plus 2 by 4 into log 2 of 2 by 4. So this is nothing but the 1. So probability of mid, so how many mid are there? There are the 4 mid out of 10. So I am considering the 1 divided, 1 multiplied by 0.4. So the value is 0.4. So mid value is 0.4. Now information of new value, okay, information of new value in attribute age. So how many new value are there? There are the 0 divided by 3 plus into log 2, 0 by 3 plus 3 by 3 log 2, 3 by 3. Okay, so again this value is nothing but the 0, and probability of the new value in your total record is 3 by 10. So 0 multiplied by 0.3 is equal to 0. Okay. So total entropy of my attribute A is equal to 0 plus 0.4 plus 0. Okay. So you can find out the entropy of the attribute A is equal to 0.4. So this is our second step, that is to find out the entropy. So in the first step, we have to find out the information gain of a target attribute. So in my example, the target attribute is profit. So I have to find out the profit information gain. In the next step, I have to find out the entropy of each attribute. So here I am through the example, I am finding out the first entropy of attribute age. You have to find out the entropy of competition. You have to find out the entropy of type. Okay. So the entropy of attribute age is nothing but 0.4. Now find the gain of all attributes. To find out the gain of all attributes means gain is equal to IG. What is IG? Information gain minus in entropy of age is 1 minus 0.4. So gain of age is equal to 0.4. Therefore gain of competition attribute is IG, all of you know that is 1. Okay, minus entropy of competition, so you have to find out the entropy of the competition. So it is nothing but 0.124, and the gain of type attribute is equal to 0. Okay, so who is having the highest gain? So the attribute age having the highest gain. So I am keeping the attribute age as a root, at root, okay, and Now you can draw your decision tree. So here, why you are selecting the age as a root? Because the answer is that the gain of the attribute age is highest as compared to the competition attribute and as compared to the type attribute. So the gain of the age attribute is 0.60, and while the gain of the competition attribute is 0.12, and the gain of type attribute is 0. So that's why I am selecting age is my root attribute, while old and new. Okay, so how many values are there? There are the two values, that is old and the new, right? So we can considering the old and new, that is the branches, and the third one is the mid, and the next one, the next gain you can find out, that is the competition. So that's why I am making this age attribute to my competition attribute, and then you can find out yes and no. So in this way you can draw your decision tree. So this is a way to draw your or make your decision tree using the numerical value. Okay. So I hope all of you know understand how to solve the numerical problem of decision tree and how to draw the decision tree on given data set using the numerical value. Okay. So such kind of example will be asked in your exam, in your NCERT exam, your CA exam. So be prepared. So here you can see that I am providing your data set. There is no numerical value, but you have to solve the decision tree problem with the numerical. Okay, so you have to convert this value into the numerical and then convert it and then to solve the your decision tree problem using your information gain formula, then entropy formula and the gain formula, right? So this is all about the decision tree. If anybody has any questions, so they can ask. Yes, is any difficulty to how to find out the information gain and all these things? Overfitting and underfitting. So this overfitting and underfitting problem is occur whenever you are using the any machine learning algorithm or mostly in the decision. So what is this overfitting and overfitting by the underfitting? So we call overfitting when you have too much data given to machine so that it becomes get confused. Okay, so in that condition we can say that is a overfitting. While underfitting, you are giving very less data to the machine learning algorithm and or machine or it not able to understand the thing. So that condition is called as the underfitting. And both conditions are very dangerous for our machine learning algorithm. So you have to avoid the overfitting as well as the underfitting. Okay, so we will see how this how we can solve this overfitting and underfitting problem. So before we start the overfitting and underfitting, let us see what is the overfitting. So overfitting means too much data given to the machine and it gets confused. While underfitting, very less data is given to the machine and it is not able to understand. So this is called as the overfitting and underfitting. Now, overfitting. Let us consider the hypothesis H is said to be overfit to the training data if there is another hypothesis dash H dash such that H dash has more error than the H on the training data, but H dash has less error than the H on the testing data. Okay, so all of you know that we are normally divide our training, our data set into the two parts, that is the training data set and the testing data set. Okay, So let us consider, we have to consider the two hypotheses H and the H dash. Okay, and when we are working on these two hypotheses H and the H dash, so H dash has more error than the H on the training data, but H has less error than the H on the testing data. So in that condition, we can say that it is an overfitting. Okay, so the overfitting, if you see the overfitting graph, so in that case, you can see this too much data given to the machine and it gets confused. So on the testing and on the training case, you can find out the training is good. When you train your machine, the output is very good. Your graph is slightly increasing and then improving. But when you are testing that machine learning algorithm during that condition, it gets slightly down. Okay, and its complexity of your decision tree is getting increased. Okay, and it is also get down. Okay, so in that condition, you can say that the overfitting is possible. And when you have the model is so simple, in that condition also the overfitting and underfitting problem is occur. Overfitting due to the noise. Okay, so this is one of the example when your overfitting is occur due to some of the noise. So here you can find out there is a plus blue plus, okay, and the red dots are there, but there is some noise point. So you can see that there is one noise point, and this noise point create an overfitting problem. Okay, otherwise this output is very nice, this output is very acceptable, right? But because of this only noise point, you are avoiding this output, or you are avoiding this what do you say that algorithm. Why? So you can see that there is a blue plus point and a red dot circle. They are classified well and good, but there is a simple one point, that point is called as a noise point, and it creates a chaos, and because of that you cannot differentiate these two data set into the two proper format. Okay, so one is not properly going to only one point, that is noise point, create an overfitting in this graph. So you can see that carefully, because of that also your overfitting problem occurred due to the noise. And this is a overfitting this is an insufficient example. Okay, so there is a misclassification point. These are the misclassified points. Okay, so lack of data points make it difficult to predict correctly the class level on that region. So let us consider I have the two labels, cross blue cross and the red circle, but this hollow circle create a misleading a misclassification. Okay, so these are also create an overfitting problem. The overfitting is so complex, your model is trying to cover every data point of the output at some point. So in some points your model is trying to cover all the data point. Okay, so in that condition also this overfitting problem is occur. And what is the underfitting? So when model is so simple, here your model is trying to cover the very few data points or output X and Y. So out of this you can see that only the 2 points or 3 points are covered by your model, even though you have a very small data. Okay, so in that condition also you can see that this is an underfitting problem. Okay, now let us consider. So let us consider that you have trained your model that if any object looks a sphere, it sphere in shape called it as a ball. Okay, so let us consider I train my machine learning algorithm. Okay, and as per my instruction, whenever my machine learning algorithm find out there is a object in a sphere shape called it as a ball. But in that condition, is it ball? Okay, so here
it is not a ball. But even though my algorithm say that it is a ball. Okay. So why happened it is? It's because of the it is very less training data set available. Okay. So we are giving only the one attribute here that only the sphere shape you call it a ball. So you can give the different attribute, number of attribute, you can increase the number of attribute. Okay. And if you are increasing the number of attribute and the data set also, so in that condition your overfitting problem is get solved. Otherwise, as per your rule, as per your formula, your machine learning algorithm is correctly answered that if there is a sphere shape, if there is a sphere shape, then it is called as a ball. And this orange in a sphere shape, so obviously it gives the answer that it is a ball, even though it is not a ball. Now, overfitting. So in this example, let us consider I have the one data set, okay, and in that data set I have the number of attributes. For example, is the size fair, or is it is used for the plane, if it is not usable, and the radius is equal to 5 centimeters. So we are providing the lots of attributes to identify the object, and given this condition, you can say that this is a overfitting problem. Okay. Now, one of the very famous overfitting problem, this is really very interesting, and it is happened during the football match. The AI camera mistakenly identified the lineman's blood head for a blow and follow it through the match. Okay, because what that camera, that AI based camera, okay, so that AI based camera is trained that if there is a sphere or a round shape, okay, you can see the round shape, so this is nothing but the ball, and you have to follow that ball only. Okay, so during the football match in Scotland, an artificial intelligence camera continuously track a lineman head mistakenly for the ball. A video of the gaffe has gone viral on the social media. The commentator had to repeatedly apologize as the camera case on the mistaking the lineman's head for the ball. Okay, so this is happened. This is a real life example. You can find out. Okay, this is a problem of overfitting. Right. So this is all about overfitting and underfitting. Okay.